Over the last 2 years, the United Nations and the US have tightened economic sanctions on North Korea like never before. But in fact, ships are still bringing oil into the country and transporting North Korean coal and other goods overseas, according to UN and US officials. Pyongyang has found creative ways to evade international sanctions, including disguises, covering tracks, and seeking ground support. Here's how North Korea manages to keep trading at sea, based on a months-long WSJ investigation. Like many terrestrial criminals, ships use disguises to cover their real identity, including fake flags. North Korea-linked operators have been caught erasing the ship's names from the hulls and paint false names and ID numbers to trick those who are watching. Some oil tankers get a more elaborate makeover, with fake cargo hatches built on them so that patrol aircraft mistake them for cargo ships. At sea, crews use your transponders, which relay the ship's position to others to broadcast a false identity. They pretend, for instance, that their ship is registered in Fiji when it is actually North Korean, or that it is a fishing vessel rather than a freighter. False signals can even give the impression the ship is longer and shorter than its actual size to confuse authorities and investigators. To hide exactly where they are going, ships choreograph voyages that make them hard to track. North Korean tankers rendezvous with other ships in the middle of the ocean, US officials say. That way, they can transfer petroleum products from those ships without having to enter a foreign port themselves. 24 North Korean tankers have made at least 148 such deliveries to North Korean ports this year, according to authorities monitoring their activities. To export coal, a ship may first loiter near a port, say in China, without actually making a visit. It manipulates its draft, which shows how much of the ship is underwater, to make it look like it has loaded coal. Next, it turns off its tracker to fetch coal from North Korea, then switches the tracker back on as it sails to other countries, like Vietnam, to deliver it. To port authorities there, it looks like the coal was from China, and fake paperwork supports that. This is how a ship called the Huafu operated, according to UN experts. Evading sanctions at sea requires support from ship owners and managers on land. The owners of these vessels are often front companies in places like Hong Kong, which makes it difficult to find out who really controls them. The ships are often registered in countries that offer flags of convenience, which means they allow foreign-owned ships to sail under their flags for a fee. Countries ranging from Panama to Togo and Palau offer this service. They have come under pressure from the UN and others to investigate their ship registries and deflag ships that may be linked to North Korea. In some cases, ship operators don't bother with registration at all. They just fake the paperwork to make it look like they have, the Wall Street Journal found. North Korea didn't respond to a request for comment. Authorities say Pyongyang has been using increasingly sophisticated techniques. North Korea-linked ships often use tactics in bundles and layers rather than one at a time, making them particularly hard to catch. Patrol aircraft face vast open seas with thousands of ships conducting legal trade. An enforcement of sanctions depends on officials and agents around the world, some of whom may be willing to help for a bribe. Although advanced ship tracking and satellite technology has helped, sanctions are tough to enforce without a high level of global cooperation. That's why, some experts argue, North Korea will likely get away with quite a bit for quite a while.